This issue of recognition, recognition for people who have served. You see, a friend of mine recently told me that a key incentive for you to be part of a group is when you observe how those who have retired are treated. You know what I'm saying? So there is some discussion as to whether we are recognizing our homegrown heroes and icons over the years. The Hall of Fame has been set up. I think that's a great move. The Youth Olympics Museum has been set up. But do you feel that more can be done to recognize our own homegrown icons? And you don't have to be necessarily 80 before you are considered an icon. You don't have to be Tan Hao Liang. There are many other people. At some point, you've retired, you've moved on, but you need to be recognized. How can this be done? And this goes back to the whole point of culture too. It goes back. Do we have a tradition of that? You know, I'd like to hear your views on that. Yes. Maybe, yes.
So I've been tasked to form...
Tasked? By whom?
By my bosses.
He's a Sport Singapore employee.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Tasked by whom?
So we are in the process of now forming a group. We need a name for this group. At one time, we thought we might call it alumni, but I think we are looking for a better name.
Paikia.
and we are saying that we want to be inclusive. That means if you have represented Singapore in sports, whether as an athlete, coach, or official, we are going to recognize you. We're going to trace them, we're going to register them, and then we are looking for some benefits for them. So that is in the pipeline.
How long is this pipe?
I'm 73 now. No, but I, you know, I'm part of it. And yeah. I really think we want to do something. And right from the top is people want to recognize and want to do things for them. So we are there. We just have to get going.
Wonderful.
But can we do what other countries are doing? 2 years ago, India came up with a scheme. If they are Olympic medalists, Asian Games medalists, and lower, they get a monthly...
Like a pension.
Pension. Olympic medalists, 10,000 rupees a month for life. And 10,000 rupees a month is like $300. You can live very comfortably in India. That's what they told me. Can we do that?
Maybe the former...
Do we need to do that? You know, this is what is happening in other parts of the world. In Korea, the same.
So basically,
in Malaysia, the same.
So basically, Kunal, what you're saying is we need to come up with incentives that that make a difference. It need not all be monetary, but
yeah.
That makes
so
a difference.
So what makes a difference for us Singaporeans, sportsmen and women who have retired?
Sure.
So that's my job now to ask, so find out, and so on.
PC Supaya has been dying to give you some ideas.
Sorry, I have to say this, you see. I've been working for Singapore Pools for 41 years. You see, so the already retired for 4 years. They just call me and says, "Okay, your time already 62. You have to leave." So I wrote in and I spoke to them. You see, what happened? Why? You see, this is our scheme. We have to reduce the staff and all that. Otherwise, we have to cut your pay for 20% and all that. Give you a different job and all these things. I say, "Okay, I have to leave." You see, I will say we have done so much. Not to say myself or whatever it is. I'm talking on behalf of every Olympians. We reached the highest spot is Olympic. We have been there. We've been participating and all that. The company should be proud of that. I have an Olympian here. You see, we can do so many things. We can bring the staff for the jogging, training and all that. You can even create something for us. You see? And I prefer what Kunal was telling. Retirement, there's no retirement for the sportsmen. They retire themselves if they are not fit. Look at me, whether I'm fit or not. You see? So I lose the job. then I have to go and create something else. So I spoke to Kuna. I'm the Olympian, we are in the committee, and spoke to Kuma. Kuma is, Kunalan is coming with something that he's going to approach and all that, you know, all this. You see, there's an Olympian who have a taxi driver, no Raza Hamid. He's a taxi driver. When we call him, he doesn't want to come, he's a taxi driver. You see, Yogi Incha is a taxi driver. You see, are we feeling proud, the Singaporean, you know, all the, you know, sportsmen, whichever Olympic, and driving taxis and all that, whichever, you know, we got to take care of them. You see, some of them, even my neighbor, Malaysia, I was born in Malacca. I'm a Malaysian. But I've been given a Singapore citizen and I'm here. But Malaysia is taking care of all the sportsmen. You see? So one way or the what sir says, you know, you don't have to give them a reward of cash or whatever. It's one way or the other. If they go to the medicals, they got special treatment. We take a bus, they got a special treatment. Or look for them a job. You see? When they got to get, the example, the schools, they have the PE teachers and all that. We can be, you know, take over that and we can promote the sports.
Okay.
You
so,
see?
So it doesn't have, it could even be medical.
Yes.
Things that are useful for you. Kadir, I saw you responding, reacting when PC was saying, you want to pass with the
because, mic? Because both of them went for the Olympic in 1972. You see, this is the one way, you know, PE teachers, you see? Yeah. That doesn't mean you must be a PE teacher. How he knows about sports? We can be a sports officer there.
We will get
do
them,
something.
I'll get them to respond to you.
Yes, please, thank you.
Yes. Kadir.
At least he was working. I have stopped my work about 30 years ago to stop working to do coaching, to help the kids, to bring up the kids. I have no salary. I do my own pocket money, whatever I did. 3/4 of my life in sports, from my competing and coaching, continue non-stop until today.
Luckily, your wife is working.
Yeah. Lucky she's working. She's very helpful to me. She knows I'm the public property. Before I married her, I told her that I'm a public property, so you don't disturb me.
Wife works for Sports Singapore.
Yeah. And that's where I met her in sports.
No, but I think you're making an important point, a very important point. This shouldn't happen.
Yeah.
I mean, personally, if you ask me as a Singapore citizen, it shouldn't happen. You know, I mean, there must be at least some form of support, financial support for people who are serving the country, serving the nation. Thank you for your contribution. Kokpan, yeah. I want to hear from you. Sorry, this has to be the last comment.
My sense is, taking back to our initial discussion where we feel that sport play a very important role to bring the youth together and hopefully they do good for the country. Similarly, in their golden years, whether the recognition in the form of medical or even, SAFRA sports team facilities, and I think the SAFRA, the NS, they have a very good sporting facilities to all the ex-NS men, and I'm one of the beneficiaries. I think that's something that we can maybe borrow some very good ideas for the folks here. But I think the key point I would like to raise is this, right? It's about what is the signal that we are sending to the community that on the one hand, we want sports to be the single defining area to bring people together, to rally, you know, and with their heart sing Singapura. And the people who are the catalysts that bring this about, at the golden years, they kind of, you know, based on the feedback, like, you know, they felt as though they're missing out on something. And I think this discussion actually warrants some very serious consideration. And when I look at our DPM, Taman, he himself was a hockey player, and I'm very, very sure he could also relate to this. He was a hockey player, taking time, and I'm sure, I think in today's world, I think in our leadership team, and after this evening's session, I have my separate discussion on NSAs, by the way, I really believe the moment is right. SG50 is a good initiative. You can actually add a bonus to many, many other sportsmen. And actually, it gives a real hope for the younger athletes that they say, hey, guess what? Symbolically, things have changed. And I think this is something that I hope, you know, the forum here, the panelists would actually put a little bit more, or not a little bit more, really put in consideration for this.
Thanks. Thank you. Thank you very much, Kwok Fan.